Hi. Today in this special episode, we have somebody I admire the most. Not because the game I love the most, but also the way she has shown that there's always a sportsman who brings you back when you fall down. We are going to talk to Mansi Joshi, para badminton world number 2 and a recent world champion. Hi Mansi, great to have you on Sportsy. Let's talk sports.
Hi sir, thank you for having me.
It's my pleasure to host you here. It's not only for the love of badminton as a game that I have, but the tremendous, I'll not say only respect, it is the whole motivational thing that your journey has been. And it's Mansi Joshi is world beater. She's a world champion. She's a world number 2, and it is a great honor for us to have you here. We will talk about some of the parts of the journey, but we just want to talk to you about what made Mansi Joshi, who won her first medal at the World Championship, Para Badminton Championship 2015, then 16, 17, and the biggest moment that which came last year in the World Championship, Para Badminton Championship. So, what is Mansi Joshi?
What do I say? Yes, my journey has been really different. It has been with its own up and down. And I have been privileged that I have got amazing friends and family members who has given me a lot of support and was motivated me, encouraged me to, you know, pursue different things. And one such thing is para sports. And yes, last year was like a big, big point for me, where I won a gold at Para Badminton World Championship in Switzerland in September, August 2019.
Yes.
So yes, it has been a journey, and I'm happy to be, you know, making or writing it in different way in different months or different years that are coming.
Yes, and I think that is what it's all about. It's the grit, the determination, and usually we say that comes with sports. So, what is the importance of sports in your life, pre and post the incident that you had?
So, yeah, I had an injury in 2011 December. I met with an accident, and unfortunately, I had to lose my left leg to the accident. But sport has been a great part of my life. Since childhood, I've been playing badminton. I have been playing multiple sports. I have gone for coaching for football, for badminton both. And I have been playing multiple sports in school, track and field also. And it's not just sports. As a kid, we all three siblings of ours, have been introduced to different things like sports, like arts, like music. I have taken part in all these things, and sports definitely has been a great part of my life, where I have my identity is shaped because of it. And post my injury, I use sports as my rehabilitation tool. And initially, my ambition was just to, you know, relearn or get back to my normal life and normal self, and sport helped me achieve this. And it was my identity. Even my college, in my office, I was working everywhere. Sports was my identity. So to get back to normal, I use sports as my tool for rehab.
And was it badminton the first choice?
I have tried many sports, but badminton was definitely not my first. I have tried track and field first. Uh-huh. But badminton became my love, and it became my a tool, I'll say.
Oh wow, okay. And the post during the rehab, was badminton was the primary motivation that you had? I'll not say motivation was the primary sport that always on the back of your mind that you had?
Definitely, because I was trained in badminton. So see, when I say I had multiple sports, it was only till when I was in 7th standard or till my 8th standard, I'll say. After that, I have just kept on pursuing badminton. I have done coaching there. I have I used to participate at various district level competition. But then even if I got selected for higher things, like higher tournaments, mm-hmm. it was always my 10th and 12th when I got those kind of right. opportunities. And I took a back seat and, said ke studies first, sports second. So this is, sport was like my, being, it was a hobby, but also an identity and a way of life. And now it has become such a great, like it has become a way of life for me. It has given me so many new directions and new hopes and ambitions.
And believe me, not only to you, it has given hope and ambition to so many other people who are admiring the way you play, the way you carry yourself and the way you've been performing. I think that is the bigger achievement for a nation.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. So, during the whole process, when you came back from the rehab, when you came to rehab and trying to develop something, what was your biggest support and what was your biggest motivation?
So, I'll say getting back to normal. I wanted, like, once I started using a prosthetic leg, I had to relearn how to, do every activity in it. And yes. First is, standing and walking in it. So initially, my biggest motivation was just to perfect my walk or just to, have a perfect hand-eye, like hand and leg and, eye coordination. And with prosthetic, it was difficult. So I used to go and play badminton with my brother, who's also a badminton player. And I learned how to balance my body because I had to take few shots, right? So
yes,
the balancing part on my prosthetic, badminton became a very important area.
Oh, nice.
And so, it has always been my parents who have motivated me and my friends who have always pushed me to, try different things. Say, my brother, there was a time when I would just come back from work completely tired by 7:30 in the evening. And my brother would say, chal hum court chalte. We had a 9 o'clock. I used to go and play from 9 o'clock to 10 o'clock or 8 o'clock to 10 o'clock, depending on the day. And I would just he's like, chal chalte hi hai. I have you only. You have to play with me. So we both used to go and play. So he used to push me, chalte hai. So that is the type of, if you have that kind of support and people around you, that it makes a great deal and great difference.
Excellent. I think that is what you said, that the family, friends and the people around you, I think it makes it a very meaningful when something like this happens. And finally, it is all about your mental strength. It is yes, how much your people want to make it happen for you, it is you the one who makes it happen for you. So was that more of a physical conditioning or more of a mental condition that you're going through, or was it a equal mix?
Well, it was initially though it was all about physical and mental both, because I was not able to do a lot of things. Even when I was playing badminton, I could not pick up a few shots, right? So my body wanted to pick it, but my mind wanted to pick it, but body was not allowing me. So yeah, definitely it was like a fight mentally and physically. But with time, I started giving it in, saying ke if few things are not possible for me, it doesn't matter. I will only focus on my strengths. And that is what I did, tried and focused on my strength and made sure that all those steps which initially I felt difficult, I started working on it one step at a time. And those initial fears turned out to be like my points where I excelled into it. So that was how initially it was.
Excellent. And since you were trained as an able athlete, you were already training in badminton, and then you picked it up this year. What was the unlearning that you had? What were the technical challenges that you actually faced? Because I have understood with somebody that I have seen that, okay, going back is something becomes very tough than coming in front. I think True. That is, yeah. So what were those and how did you overcome those challenges?
So you are right, Sid. Going backwards is a little tough for people who have amputation, above knee amputation, because you require support of a functional knee and a functional ankle. And badminton is all about footwork.
Yes.
So I'm not as fast as I was before, but I have to play half court. Our game is based only in half court of the area. Okay. So definitely those things the current prosthetics that are available in the market, they are made for designed for forward motion. And if you consider it for running, walking, but badminton requires your backward and sideways movements also. And if I play, I'm playing doubles also, which is a full court game. So definitely I can't say, you know, that it's just a game of a half court. I have to cover a lot of area. I require different movements. So, you know, making up my mind, unlearning all those things, making peace with it that, you know, going back is difficult. You better learn going backwards more. Better practice going backwards more. Yeah. Because also you tend to lose balance while going backwards. Even going on my left hand side, I have fallen so many times while I'm on my, if I put more weight on my left hand side, and it's scary. Also you lose out a lot of confidence once you fall. But then it's a part of who we are and who what sport teaches you. I think with time, I've found more balance with my body. And of course, it's a process and I'm learning.
Right. I think everybody says that sports teaches you to stand up when you fall down. I think you have the right example, and it's a right analogy, and that's what the mindset is. That the sportsman attitude is what we are known for, and it's really hats off to you the way you've been doing it. So you trained for a couple of years before you actually came into the international circuit after the rehab. So you were coaching with people who may not be completely trained to coach para badminton player. So was it a difference? Did you feel the difference between the coaching of for any coach at that level, coaching a normal athlete or a para athlete?
So I have been training and I've been playing with various people. My first coach has been my brother, who has been very considerate and understanding my ups and downs, also my agility. He's very focused on, you know, what is right for me, what is not right for me. But once he started his higher education, I had to find other people who had similar ambitions like mine. So I started training in Ahmedabad and then shifted to Hyderabad. Of course, initially you have to be more vocal, like as a para athlete. I think as any athlete, you have to be more vocal. To tell what is working for you and what is not working for you. I think for people who teach you how to, especially like coaches, if you make them understand what you really require, I don't think, you know, that people treat you any differently. So I'm happy and lucky that I've got some great support and great coaches who have tried to understand my ambition, my physical limitation, and also my ability, and guiding me to maximize whatever I can in the best possible way.
Wow. And what was your biggest unlearning in the whole process? Everybody talks about learning. I just want to know, what was your biggest unlearning in the whole process?
Unlearning, I'll say, you know, to let go of things that you think you don't wish to do or you think are not really important. Because as an athlete, as an engineer, we always want to finish everything. Yes. Sab exams, matlab 5 din mein padhai karke pass to karna hi hai. 40 plus to lana hi tha. That was what our ambition was when, you know, we were preparing for engineering. So, letting it go, okay, ye chapter chodna hai. And, you know, chapter chodna and, you know, life mein se wo chapter chodna. That has been the biggest
learning.
Okay, don't have to, you know, worry too much about few things, and eventually it will happen. It's going to be slow, but eventually it's going to happen.
So I think it's very well said. It's about letting go things is even, it's really, really important for to have a conscious, mindful, happy life. You should know how to let go things. And I think that is,
Better, earlier you learn about how to let go, better it is for your mental health and for your future.
Yes. So, Mansi, you've been competing at international level for the last 5 years now, almost 5 years. In that, what has been your biggest challenge as an athlete? What have been your biggest challenges to compete at the international level? And obviously we can align the same challenges to domestic level, but since we are talking about, I'm talking to a world champion, I just want to talk about the international level things and not the national level things. So what have been the biggest challenges?
See, challenges are multiple. As para athletes, we have to face way more number of challenges than able-bodied athletes.
Yes.
But I'll say it's not like all sports. If you consider the sports which are not recognized, they face similar situation. One is athlete finance.
Right.
Number two will be finding, like as para athletes, finding people who understand your dreams and ambition and help you achieve that. There are times that, you know, I have been fortunate that I've got amazing people, but there are times when people who wish to start a sport and they have a physical impairment, it is difficult for people to, you know, give them training. People don't understand ke this person can become a world champion in future if you start early.
Yes.
So grassroots level training is tough. For me, it was easy because I was a player before as an able-bodied athlete. So I feel for newbies or people who want to start, that is a challenge. Another thing I'll say is para sport is not, I'm really sad to see how things are. People with disabilities are treated in our country. If you see our infrastructure, if you see our accessibility, we don't see more people with disabilities outside because we don't have that kind of infrastructure. If
Correct.
You see people with disability, they're awesome, amazing. 80% of people will say, I don't have any disabilities. Like, I don't care if I have any disabilities. Such is the attitude. And physically, it is tough to maneuver on a broken footpath or not having lift to go into a building. And it definitely demotivates you. Also, people with disabilities they don't have much education. I mean, of course, privileged are the ones who have, but then education, job opportunities, these are one another challenge. For me, as an athlete, I have faced, there are times when I feel that it's a little discriminatory. It's a very strong word that I'm putting on your platform, but there is discrimination of able-bodied athletes and para-athletes at various levels. Not at the training, but in the government, because schemes are not there for para-athletes. Mm-hmm. Even if you, like, one sport is how how Olympic Games and Paralympic Games are perceived all over the world. But I think in India, we are taking time to call Olympic Games and Paralympic Games together.
Yes.
As the same link in the lingo itself.
Correct.
And we need more people who you know, talk about rights for people with disability. Just like for feminism, we require male support. In the similar way, for disabled rights, we require everybody's support who are able-bodied. And then only we will be able to achieve all those things. Of course, prosthetics, equipment, they're expensive. If I go travel long distance, I have to take halts, I have to take off my prosthesis, give some air, breathing time, etc. And all these things are not considered for able-bodied athletes. So definitely it's a different challenge that we para-athletes face. And every para-athlete, I'll tell you this one thing, every para-athlete is different. An able-bodied person, you will say only five or six categories, like men's doubles, women's doubles, singles, and this. And people have similar body structure, similar ability and all. But here, everybody's impairment is different.
Yes.
And, you know, it's a challenge. It's a great opportunity for people to learn, especially for physios, for trainers and coaches to, have such kind of trains people like us. And there are multiple challenges, Sid. And
I can understand.
This is what makes para athletes really different, resilient, if you see. And this is one more attitude of para athletes, I think, which people appreciate and love.
Yes, and that is what. I've known you for some time and heard about it many times. But after the last year's world championship and when you went on KBC, that was a big moment. And that also gave you a lot of visibility. I think that is something was also required for people to know. Mansi has just won the world championship, but before that she had 7 different medals at international level that probably were not known to people outside the fraternity. So I think those kind of platforms were really required. And what you said, everybody has to come together to make a right voice and right statement for the para-athletes.
Definitely, that's so true. And it's like a kind of a validation you get after having a good performance. When people also appreciate it, and when you get called, meet Amitabh Bachchan, sit in on the hot seat. Like, who doesn't have an ambition of sitting on the hot seat, right? Like, everyone. So, yeah, and it's not just 7 medals, 7 major medals I can say I would have won. But of course, there are countless other medals and other open tournaments that we have participated and won. And yes, it is great to be, have opportunity to play for a country. Right. And I think a medal is a medal. Doesn't matter at what level, in which country you win. Whatever you win for your country, whatever you win for yourself is of an importance.
Believe me, the moment you wear the India jersey and the moment you stand on the podium, I think everything else is secondary. So when you spoke about the whole journey and the financial things, what is it? You have a few sponsors who are supporting you in the journey, like Wellspun, Malcolm or Automotive. So what has been their role in your journey?
So I don't come under some schemes. Like, we have top schemes in India which support athletes who are probables at Olympic Games, Olympic and Paralympic Games. But I am not a part of the scheme because my event as a singles event is not a Paralympic event. So, unfortunately, we don't get that kind of financial support from the government. State level support also is not there. So, my sponsors are the people who take care of all my needs, right? From travel to my tournaments and every training, etc. All the needs. And it is of a great relief, to have somebody back you up so that you can go and pursue your dreams and ambitions. And people and companies who help, like, they have been a part of my journey since many years now. And I'm so glad that I've got 3 corporates now backing me up for my journey. Also, I was a part of OJQ team. I have been, I'm happy that, Gopi sir and his team and everybody is, helping and supporting. So financially, you require help. A sport is a very expensive hole in the pocket. Also, as a para athlete, our equipments, like my prosthetic costs me 22 lakh and I need to replace it every 5 years. So it's kind of a huge cost that I have to bear. So my prosthetics may come, like I might have to replace my current prosthetic and I was hoping this year, but luckily it is surviving. It has been almost 8 years now me using the prosthesis. We require all these people to help you. My sports prosthesis, which I use to play badminton, is sponsored by my sponsor. So, I have got great support and this is the reason why I'm able to, do so many things instead of worrying about finances.
Correct. And I think it's, I work in the sports commercial side and I do work with people like MS and other, where you work on the branding and commercial side of it. But those are the different deals. But when a corporate company supports this, I think that is phenomenal. And that's where the culture of corporate also is seen. But they mean something about it. It is not only doing it for the heck of it or for the branding side of it. It is actually going one step beyond branding and being conscious enough to give it back and also have a right attitude from the top down in the company.
Exactly. Like, this kind of sponsorship is not to fill my pockets. It's to support my journey. Exactly. So it's a noble cause the corporates have chosen and I'm glad to be part of their journey. I mean, glad to be part of their roster.
Yes, and the CSR being such a huge aspect for Indian sports, and only hardly 1% of the CSR money is coming into sports right now. There is a tremendous scope, and even though CSR, I know as at the commercial level, CSR happens out of compulsion or emotion. either way, if it comes to sports, even the 10% of the money comes to sports, I think we'll see phenomenal growth in Indian sport, the way it can
that
grow.
Is so true. CSR, I'm so glad that companies are changing perspective.
Yes.
And putting in a lot of money into CSR through into sports. I'm happy that, you know, I have my sister Nupur, who is also a sports person. Yeah. So even, you know, her inputs, her knowledge adds up a lot, and it was only because of you know, working with, like, my brother is my coach, my sister is a sports business manager.
Yes, she's your manager, and she's doing it well.
So you require, like, I have got a great team in my home only. I don't have to go outside. Ki bhai mujhe batao kya karna chahiye, mujhe kisse approach karna chahiye. I know the answers. I just have to have like. She knows how to do it.
And I have interacted with Nupur many times, and I think this is she exactly knows what she wants. Her priority is Mansi, and she makes it happen. So which is really good. And it's phenomenal to have that support in the house when you trust the most than outsider. So Mansi, last couple of questions. One is about your message to the para athletes who are training and looking, having their own goals, which are life goals or the sporting goals. What is your message to them?
So, I would like to tell other para athletes who are in the initial phase of representing our country, I would like to tell them that finances are going to be a great struggle, but never shy away to share your story to the world. Never shy away to approach government organizations, NGOs and corporates. Take some time, interact with more people who have, you know, done this. Talk to them. Don't shy away from talking to seniors. Just contact them if you don't know how to. Just go to their social media, contact them and ask them for support. Be genuine. And I think as para athletes, we have to remain more and more in, like, have unity. And so that is one point. Other thing I'll say is keep on working hard. There will be times when people won't understand what you really mean, but once you keep on doing it every time, every minute, people will eventually, the right people will eventually come, become a part of your team and try and understand and help you achieve your ambitions and goals. But to do that, you have to keep on approaching people, and networking is the key. Everywhere you go, talk to people, and it's not just for business professionals, even for athletes. It is, you have to know other people, you have to know other athletes, you have to know their struggles, listen to more stories of people who have had similar paths. Don't try and, you know, create your own path. That is only once you reach to a particular level you have to do it, but initially it's all made up. You just have to go and live it.
Yes. And what do you have to say about the education? I think for you, the education has, you were well educated, working, and then this happened. But earlier we spoke about some of the para athletes are not well educated. So how do you think the education plays a role in making what you are?
So I'll tell you one thing, that as a person with disability, you have to have a great knack for knowledge. It doesn't matter if, you know, education, paper pay, it's okay. Like, you can have your own degrees, but you should have that hunger for knowledge to learn and unlearn new skills. Other thing is, for people, it is a mandatory thing. Okay, you know, if a person is educated, is able to speak good English, people have that kind of, people have more appreciation for them. So, put that kind of time in building up your identity. It does. It's not a rocket science. Nothing is a rocket science. You just have to work hard. And because we have an impairment, we have to put in more effort. That is there. Like, you have to, matlab, aur kuch option hi nahi hai.
Excellent. So, again, what is your... now I'm coming to the area where I just want to have the motivation side of you for people to understand. What is your message to the parents of athletes of both, able, disabled, both? What is the message to the parents? Because they play a big role in the whole system.
I think I'll tell you about my father. So my father came from a very small town from Gujarat, and he did his education from a very not so well-known university, but he turned out and became a scientist at Bhabha Atomic Research Center.
Oh, wow.
And his best, like his quality was one, like he learned all the sports after he came to Mumbai. He started mm-hmm. with tennis, he started with badminton, table tennis, karate, he was nuns, like, ghar mein itne nuns ko unko khelte. I was like, wow, crazy. So he has learned everything at a later age, later stage. And he has been the one who has motivated, like my mother and father both have motivated us to have different kind of knowledge, not just yes. bookish, because books, matlab, it gives you a lot of knowledge, but definitely to have a strong social skill, you have to also have other co-curricular activities like sports, music, arts, anything which is of a person's yes. Interest. And I think the life skills that you learn from all mm-hmm. the other activities like music or arts or sports, it remains with you. And no identity, like I think for parents need to understand this. Parents need to encourage their children. I think this COVID time where one vacation, one person, like a child's vacation has been spent in four corners of a house. Unka bachpan, yakin se bachpan ja raha hai ye char diwari
mein.
So yes. I think for parents, it is really important to encourage kids to have multiple interest and encourage kids to do that. Like I know mobile phones are taking a lot of time and so much of screen time people are spending. I think parents have to, like, I'll say koi option nahi hai. Parents ka ek kaam hai bas bachcho ko encourage karo, give them an opportunity to inculcate different habits away in your house as well as outside your house.
Yes.
And I think you see in Gopichand Academy, there are parents who bring their kids at 4:45 ka session. At 4 o'clock, 4:30, wow. they start from their house. And these kids after that 4:40, like 7 o'clock session, they go to the school, finished everything. Then again, they come in the evening session also. So that is the kind of motivation I'm seeing. And these are the types that parents are encouraging the kids. And I yes. think they are future world champions.
Excellent, excellent. So now, since you're on the topic of world champion, what is next for Mansi after the world championship?
So as I said, my singles is not an event at Paralympic Games 2020. I am hoping to qualify through mixed doubles with mm-hmm. my partner Rakesh Pandey, with whom I had won 2015 world championship silver yes. medal. We are little behind in the race, and mm-hmm. we are hoping still to get selected based on the different quotas that BWF has sanctioned. That is one next thing. Also, I want to look, because I've understood how important it is to have physical literacy since mm-hmm. childhood. I think I want to spend more time in understanding, educating people about it. I want to, get into a mode where I start educating people about, different things in sports and anything which can change people's wow. life. I want to be a part of, like, how the people with disabilities, especially, it is so tough for us. So I want to be a part to, I want to be a change maker in this area. And I'm so glad that I have got sports as a tool to have an identity and yes. have got a voice. And I'm lucky to be a sports person. I'm lucky to have people around me who understand it, and I wish to have maximum number of people to just join this cause in future.
Excellent, Mansi. I think as it is said that every life has a story and only few makes it into a motion picture. I think you have made it into a motion picture. Great job. Excellent. Keep inspiring people. Keep on doing the great work. And we really want to see more and more appearances from you on the international podiums. And keep inspiring and keep smiling and be safe. And just happy to be talking to you.
Thank you, Sid. And thank you for having me, giving me a chance to share my views with you and people at Sportsy. And I wish you the very best and hope we have more interaction in future. And you also be a part of, you know, changing the new script that we all are writing.
Yes, and I'm trying to do my bit, and that is my passion. I will till the last moment of what I'm my working thing, non-working thing, I will be in sports. So that is what the whole thing is about me.
Like, that is the thing about sports. Once you are into sports, you can't leave it. You just yes. have to. I'm an example. I think you are also an example.
Yes.
Nupur is the example, my sister.
Yes.
She's a basketball player. So I think that is the thing you see in sports. So, great. Yeah. Great.
Yes.
Thank you for having
great. Me. Great. Thank you. Thank you. And Mansi, take care and stay safe.
You too. Bye.
Bye.